described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Films Media Group presents Beyond Genetics. Two mice have different color fur.
These mice are genetically identical. So why are they so different from each other?
Identical twins start out exactly the same genetically.
So why do they become so different biologically as they get older?
Can what we do and what happens to us really affect the way our genes function?
And could our parents be passing on more than just their genes?
These are questions that are challenging the very basis of genetics. And they're taking us well beyond the age-old question of nature versus nurture.
Titles: Beyond Genetics. 1. All in the Genes. Jennifer Smith.
Are you sick of your parents trying to control your life, giving you instructions about what you should do, how you should look, even who you should be?
Claire Parsons.
Well, that's nothing. They were giving you instructions before you were born.
And genetics has taught us there's no getting away from these instructions, as they're in practically every cell of your body.
Wrapped up tightly inside the nucleus of your cells is your DNA that contains most of the genetic instructions for making the proteins that make and maintain you. And these instructions come in duplicate, half from your mother and half from your father. So you see, they were on your case before you were even born. And it's these instructions that play a major part in making you, for example,
tall,
not so tall,
dark,
fair,
easygoing,
or not.
The 20th century has been called the century of the gene. Technological innovations were giving access to life at the subcellular level, a micro world never seen before, a factory of cells, molecules and proteins.
And by the second half of the 20th century, this research had given rise to a new model of gene function, sometimes called the central dogma. Genetic information is encoded in the cell's DNA. The DNA is transcribed into small, portable RNA messages. This is then translated to make proteins, the building blocks of life. And this process is called gene expression.
So, if you wanted to understand why a living thing works in the way it does and why it sometimes goes wrong, you had to track down the genes responsible.
And it seemed barely a week went by when you weren't being told researchers had done just that and tracked down the genes apparently causing or contributing to this or that disease.
And genetics went well beyond health and illness. There were genes that made us aggressive, obese, intelligent, or not, happy or sad.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.